Hey guys, this is Hetu and welcome back to ETL QLabs. So today we will look at one of the important interview scenario where we will basically validate the data between source and target, and where source is CSV file and target is relational database, right? So this is something where we have to basically use some sort of program writing or cell scripting or maybe Python scripting, right? This is the way how we can actually solve this, right? Because we need to connect to the database and then we also have to basically read the data from the file, right? So let's try to see how we can solve this, because if we have the source and target both as a relational database, then we could have used some sort of minus query and other stuff, right? But here, since source is CSV or it's the file system, and then your target is relational database SQL, and that is the reason we need to use a scripting language to basically compare the data between source and target. Yeah, what exactly we want to achieve it, we want to see that whether we have the complete data which is in the source has been loaded into target or not, right? So this is what basically we want to do it, right? So let's try to understand first. Yeah, so this is called data completeness check as well, right? So data completeness check in ETL testing says that all the records from source are basically loaded into target or not. This is what the data completeness check. Yeah, now how do we verify this? Let's try to understand this, the structure of the source, target and expected output, right? So source is emp.csv, and we have three fields in that particular CSV file: enumber, ename, department number. And then there are six records, employee number 1 to 6, and the details are here. Okay, now we have target, which is database, and the table name is EMPL. So this is basically my SQL database, and my database is having three records, 1 to 3. Now I have in my source, I have six records. In my target, we have only three records. I want to make sure that all the data are loaded, all the data is loaded. If not, then tell me which are basically missing records which are not loaded in my target. So obviously 1, 2, 3 are loaded, and 4, 5, 6, these are the one which are not loaded. My output should be 4, 5, and 6. This is what exactly I am expecting. Okay, yeah, so this should be my output, so that once I get this output, and then exactly I know that these are the records which are not loaded, and I can go and verify if there is any sort of filter or any sort of error or anything that has occurred during the ETL processing, right? So this will be helpful for me to investigate, right? So first of all, we need to understand the data completeness checks actually. So this is called the data completeness checks, right? Now what we will do is, let me try to show you basically the source and target as well, right? So let me show you first source here. So if I go here, okay, so I'm just running this. Okay, it's already there. Let me just run it. And data frame, so we have 1 to 6, right? Employee number. So this is my source, right? Now in terms of target, it is my database, right? So I will go and I'll run it and show you. So this is my database, right? And this is my target, 1, 2, 3. Now what I want is basically I want 4, 5, and 6, which are not loaded basically. Yeah, what exactly we have to do is, we have to use, we will be using here, we can do couple of things, right? One thing is we can write a cell scripting, right? Or we can use the Python scripting, or you can do any other way as well, right? But we will be using here Python pandas. As I mentioned, this is very powerful module, Python pandas, right, library, and that is what we are going to use it, right? So now as part of our approach, what exactly we need to do, we need to actually create two data frames. One data frame will contain this particular data from CSV file, and the other one will be other data frame will be containing the output of this particular SQL, right? Basically from the table, right? So two data frame, then I will compare both of them. Whichever is not matching, that will be actually my resultant, right? Simple, right? Now let's try to see how exactly we have to do it now, right? Now what we have to do, first of all, I need to make a connection to the database, right? So let me do one thing. What I will do, I will basically import the connection details, right? So I have some already written the connection details, etc. Let me basically copy paste it. This is something that you can always reuse it. Only thing is, let me explain you here, right? So these are the basically the libraries that you have to connect from PY, MySQL, SQL Alchemy, create engine, and then connect here. And then also import the pandas, obviously, because we need to create the data frame. And then you create a connection, right? So this is how actually you provide the connection detail. Create engine, this is connection detail. And then after that, you actually write the connection detail. So this entire thing is not going to be changed. Only change is basically, if I can tell you in MySQL, this is my port number of my SQL. And this is my schema database, which I am connected. And then this is my username, root is my username, this is password. This is the four changes that you can do in your connection. Remaining everything is going to be same basically, okay? So let me actually copy paste. I don't want to write such a this thing because this is something that we don't remember on top of our head, right? So this is, we can reuse it, okay? Let me go here. I just want to remove everything here. This also I want to remove, no need to have it basically. Okay, now let me write it here. All right, now this is basically my, let me run it basically. Now connection is created. What exactly I want to do here is basically I want to write a query first, right? So what query will give me? So we already have query, right? So let me write query equals, right, I'm going to say select star from empl, right? This is what it is in query. Let me show you. Yes, no, so this is what, so I want the output here, right? This output basically I want, that's why I have to write this particular query, right? And now this is the query is basically done. Now let me go to the next line here. Okay, next. One second. Yeah, now what I will do is I will basically use pandas module to read this data from this query and connections, right? So what I will do, pd.read_sql, this is the function basically that we have to use to read the data from the from that particular query connection, right? Now I have to write it here, query, and then here connection, to return this connection. No, so then this is the basically we have to go in. Now what I will do, I will store the output. This will give me the output like this basically. This output will be coming like this, right, in this format, right? Now what I will do is I will basically store this into a data frame. So I'll say df_target because this data is basically my target. No, okay, so I'll just say and run it now. All right, now if I can just run it, df_target, let's see if we are able to fetch the data from the database or not, right? So let's run it. Oh wow, look, this is the data from our database, right? This is exactly same data from the database. We are able to connect and we are able to fetch this data based on this query. Now I have CSV file, isn't it? So let me actually create a connection. I will create another data frame, right, for reading my data from my CSV. So I'll say pd.read_csv emp.csv, correct? This is my CSV file where my source is having all this data. Let me show you first, right, like what all the things we got it. Now if I can just run it, df_source, then it will show you what all the things that is there. Now this CSV data which I have shown you, right, 6 records, 126 employee number, it is basically captured in my data frame df_source, and the output from my target table is basically captured in df_target. Got it? Now we can clearly see we have got two data frame. Now what exactly we have to do? Now we have to write something to compare these two data frames, right? Basically I will compare source data minus target data, right? So then I will get what is basically remaining in the source are not loaded into my target. This is what we have to do, correct? So let's try to write something that we have to say df underscore target first of all. Df underscore source, basically source minus target I'm going to say. So source and let me see, I think it is e number, right? This is, I'm going to basically compare only one record here, okay? Basically I'm just checking whether my employee number is there in source and target both are not, like that, right? So I have to say like this, and I have to say is in. This is the function basically that I'm going to use here, okay? Now I'll say df underscore target, okay? And here I will say emp number. This is the same column name, right? Let's see. Yeah, exactly. Target is having this particular name of the column. All right. So this is what it is basically. Now let's try to emp number. Okay, one second, guys. Okay, let me try to run it and let's see what we get. Oh, exactly, we are getting it, no? So now what exactly we are seeing is whatever is matching between source and target. So this is my source, employee number from the source, and this is my target. Now when I looked at it, I see that my source and target, one second, no? So so only three are matching, correct? No, out of six only three are matching. So I want the one which are not matching, right? So how I can do? I can actually use my negation operator. Negation operator is where exactly it is here, right? So let's try to run and see what exactly. Now it is saying these are the false basically, which were true before. Now it is false. Now I will simply use df. Okay, here actually I can use df underscore source. Okay, and then I can use this entire thing inside this so that I will get all those which are not matching, actually all the false, I mean true here in this case, right? So let's try to run it. Wow, wonderful. Now you see 4, 5, and 6, this is exactly I wanted, isn't it? So if you see, my source is 1 to 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and my target is what? My target was basically 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3 is common basically. This is already loaded. What is not loaded is basically 4, 5, 6, right? From the source. So you can see 4, 5, and 6. Correct? Now, moreover, you can also basically store this into a particular data frame. Maybe I can say df underscore result. Okay. Now this is actually stored in a data frame. Now, if you want, you can actually read result. You can actually write into a particular CSV file as well. So let me see. Because if you want to store this result for the future analysis, you can just write into another CSV file. Okay. So I'll say here data completeness checks dot CSV. This is the result, isn't it? From the data completeness. Now I'm going to write, and then what I will do is, I don't want the indexes, so I'll say index equal to false. Okay. Let's run it, guys, and then see what exactly we are going to get actually here. So let me run it. All right. Now if I can go here and I can just see if I have df, I have this file created or not, right? So I can just go here and I can say pd.read underscore CSV. Now here, okay. Now if I can just run it, and if I say df here, you see, this is the file which is already permanent file, which I have written in my local where this script is at the same location. And this is the data in this. So this is the output actually. This is I wanted, right? So this is what exactly I wanted to basically, ensure that we... All right, guys. So let me also show you the file. So this is the location, right? Let me show you the file that we have created, basically the output one, right? So let me show you. You see this? This is the file basically is created, and this shows that this is my output, right? Now based on this output, I can go and trace it why these particular records are not loaded in my target and all. This is the exact number of record which are not loaded basically in my target, right? And that's all for this video, guys. And I hope that this is really helpful for you. And yeah, until we see you next time, I'll happy learning. God bless you. Bye.